And Audrey's about to feel that pressure with her first appointment, a demanding bride with high expectations.
Hi.
Hi.
Sonya.
My name is Sonya Allen. I come into a room and demand a presence in the room.
Hi, oh, you're gorgeous. Hi, I'm Audrey.
Thank you. Nice to meet you. I love you already.
And to help her find what she's looking for, she's brought along her closest friends and her son, Scott.
Do you have any ideas how you want to look?
I'm looking for a dress that has an enormous train, and I envision the top to be a corset style.
Actually, that dress right there.
That one?
Yes. I think the skirt is what she's been talking about.
Just that kind of style, the real poofiness, big on the bottom.
That's a gorgeous gown, gorgeous, gorgeous gown. It's 25,000. All the way out there.
Oh.
Out there.
Out there.
Yeah.
Price point?
3,000.
All right, come on. We'll be back.
Sonya's looking for a wow dress on her wedding day, but $3,000 is not a lot to get that dress.
Come on in.
Okay.
Have a seat. Tell me a little about the wedding so I get an idea of where you're getting married.
Yep. In a place called Water's Edge. We'll be getting married outside on a lawn facing the ocean. My fiance's name is John Roth. We have been together for 15 years. Early on in our relationship, he proposed, but at that point, the ring that he was going to get me was not the ring that I envisioned. And I said, nope, when you're ready, that's the ring I want.
Let me get a close look.
Put your glasses on.
Fabulous. Sonya didn't want to settle for a little modest ring. I kind of tipped my hat off to her.
Sonya was willing to wait 15 years for the ring and the wedding of her dreams. And now that moment has finally arrived.
You have shopped.
I have. The dresses that I have tried on have just been okay. But they haven't been Sonya.
I'll be right back, Sonya.
Okay.
It's a lot of frustration having a certain vision of a dress and not being able to find it. Will I find it today? I'm not sure.
Audrey makes a beeline for the one dress she thinks will satisfy a bride with high expectations but a modest budget.
Sonya's very picky, and I know the dress that I want to put on her. It's the right price point, and it has everything she's looking for, everything.
The only problem is, she can't find it.
Dress is in here. It's just not here.
And now she's put Randy on the hunt, too.
I need help. I think we should both go there. You take the back, I take the front.
And we'll meet in the middle.
Okay. That's ugly.
Don't hold back now. Audrey's going into panic mode right now. What about this one?
I hate it.
Really?
I don't think she's looking for that.
She knows the dress that Sonya's gonna love, but we can't find it.
I don't like this. This is too traditional.
Oh, here's the one I was thinking originally.
Oh, that's the one I was looking for.
Yes, 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 yes.
I was extremely happy when we found the dress. But I wanna do this one first. This is the one I was looking for, and I couldn't find it. I wanna mess up your hair.
Ugh.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay.
Oh my God. Oh.
It's gorgeous.
It's beautiful.
Really nice.
You want to take a step down for just one moment, Sonya?
Oh, wait, let me grab this.
Oh,
hang
yes.
on a minute, honey.
Oh, yes.
The first dress Audrey picks for Sonya is the perfect dress for her. And it's within her price point.
I don't think you've tried anything like this before.
No.
You haven't been.
Absolutely not.
But having tried on so many dresses, her judgment could be a little clouded. So how do you feel?
I love it. I love the dress, absolutely love the dress.
I love it on you too, honey, it's gorgeous.
The dress was exactly how I envisioned. It looks so amazing.
I was flabbergasted, it was nice.
It's not your typical wedding dress.
Mm-mm. And I'm not your typical bride.
Sonya?
Yes, Randy?
Is this your dress?
This is my dress.
Are you saying yes to the dress?
I'm saying yes to the dress.
Yeah!
My dress is absolutely gorgeous. It definitely looks like Sonya.
Oh. Oh, go hug your mother.
To see such emotion from her, I wanted to cry myself when I seen her dress because it's very beautiful. This is finally what she's been waiting and talking about for like years now, so it's finally happened.
Here you go, Mama.
Great job, Audrey. Great job. Great job.
After trying on so many dresses, the first dress that I've tried on is amazing.
Audrey hits a home run with the first dress. Out in the lobby, consultant Jessica heads to her next appointment, a divorce lawyer that's ready to give love a second chance.
Hi, Candace.
Hi, my name is Candice Triscola. I am 40 years old, and this is my second marriage.
Hi, how are you?
Nice to meet you. Lori.
Jessica, Lori.
I brought with me today one of my closest, dearest friends, Lori. Very excited.
Good, okay.
Being a divorce attorney can easily jade you to relationships, and I didn't think that I was going to get married again, quite honestly. I never thought that I would get this chance again. My fiance's name is Michael, and he has the biggest heart in the world. After I was divorced for a long time, it was my son and I. But there's always been something missing, and with Michael, I feel like it's not missing anymore.
So tell me about the venue, about what you're looking for.
Oh my gosh, the venue is a place called Osborne Castle in Garrison, New York.
Okay.
It is a magnificent castle that sits up on this ridge above the Hudson River. It's gorgeous. I'm looking for a dress that's a little edgier, something very different. My first wedding, it was a fairly plain, traditional bridal gown, but it wasn't really reflective of my personality. And at this point in my life, I'm gonna be all me.
Price point, where are you comfortable at the max, like having it?
I would like to keep it around 4,000.
Okay, perfect. Let's do a little shopping then.
Okay, we'll definitely do that one. You know what, I will try it. I didn't try my first wedding.
Candice's first choice immediately strikes a chord.
Oh my gosh.
You ready for her?
I'm ready.
Wow. Do you like it?
Yes.
What do you think?
Yeah. I would like to see, though, what you're going to do.
How that's going to work?
How that's going to work, though. I wasn't thinking wedding when I saw the black trail. You have to try on the other one.
I love the black tulle. I think it's funky. It has an energy that is really me.
Disappointed by her friend's disapproval, Candice heads back to the dressing room.
Where do we go from here?
You know, I think I'm gonna go with this one next. Okay.
It's beautiful.
The fabric is really cool. It's very simple, it's romantic, it's whimsical, it's a softer feel.
It's very pretty. This dress is beautiful. It shows off her figure. I could absolutely see Candice getting married in this dress.
Is it directly competitive with the other one, or do you like one more than another?
You know,
they're totally different.
And I don't know now. I thought I really loved the other one the best,
so
and now I'm confused.
So sales director Joan is called in and suggests a time-tested strategy.
Let's play the eye chart game.
Joan suggests an interesting approach, going back and forth between the two dresses.
Look very carefully.
In order to be able to see immediately the difference between the two.
And open.
Okay, this is one.
Your face right now.
The answer was just plain and clear. Her emotions answered it for her.
This is your dress.
You know the answer.
It's obvious. That was easy.
That was easy.
Let's put you in it for real.
Come on out.
That's so pretty.
This is exactly what I envisioned.
I love it. It's absolutely beautiful.
This dress takes my breath away.
Is this your dress?
This is absolutely my dress.
It's beautiful.
Oh my gosh, you're crying. It's not about a dress today. I don't think that she'd actually visioned that this day was really going to happen and that everything else would be right all around her.
I love it.
Thank you so much. I just feel very fortunate. It's almost like a fairy tale or a dream come true.